Welcome to Module 2, Unit 1 of GST 202, Fundamentals of Peace Studies and Conflict Resolution. Don't forget, this is a general studies course, and you must pass it. So make sure you take part effectively in all we are doing in this course. It's a two-unit course. Module 2, Unit 1 has to do with dynamics of conflict, that is, relationship between perception. Introduction. You will learn in this unit the basic relationship between perception and conflict and how individual group views and understand certain issues or how situations can improve to make and promote cordial and proper relationship. The intended learning outcomes are, at the end of this unit, you should be able to distinguish between perception and conflict. You should be able to identify barriers to social perception and why managers study perception. You should be able to discuss the perception of characteristic framework. You should be able to describe the causes of conflict. Relationship between perception and conflict. Conflict arises when individuals and people in communal and organizational settings perceive that others represent threats to the accomplishment of their goals. Don't forget that our definition of a conflict is that there must be competition or there must be contestation. And when you perceive that somebody can disrupt or threaten your goals, then regardless of whether these threats are real or engage in conflict. Perception characteristics framework. Perception and the environment. People's actions, emotions, feelings, and thought processes. And seen in this regard, the perceptual process and meanings, transition from perception to action, perception and cognition, perception and needs satisfaction. What are the causes of conflict framework? Perception and common resources. That is, if you are fighting for common resources and you perceive that somebody is going to hinder your achievement, then perception and values. If somebody threatens your value, your religion, your belief system, what you cherish, and you attack, our perception and psychological needs, the need to be loved, the need to gain recognition, etc., psychological needs. Barrier to proper perception, selective perception, stereotyping. First impression error about somebody. Implicit personality theories. Self-fulfilling prophecies about somebody saying this is what is likely to become or this is likely to be what will happen. Assumptions that guide managers dealing with employees. The notion that people are basically lazy and should be controlled. If you go in dealing with your employees with this belief system, you are likely to be harsh or to be a slave driver. The notion that organizations are basically successful because they are large, because many people come together, that is why we achieve. This may be erroneous. And the notion that leaders that have mastered the art of speaking are logically good leaders. Well, this may be true, and at times may not be true. It can just be somebody who's engaged in rhetoric, telling you the same story all over. The notion that organizations that are insensitive to their employees are usually the large ones. That is, the more there are many people in the organization, the less that people will get attention. And the notion that people tend to be generally emotional towards situations that confront them. The notion that a productive employee always turns out a satisfied worker. Well, these are some of the things that determine your perception about conflict. Self-assessment. Why do you think wrong perception is a major cause of inter-ethnic conflicts in Nigeria? It is all that people fight because they believe that somebody thinks is superior to their own ethnic group, or that somebody is cheating them who is from another ethnic group, or that somebody has overtaken the political system of their area who belongs to a different ethnic group, why they are sidelined. In summary, in this lesson, We have looked at perception, which entails experiencing the environment as an active process. Individuals selectively notice different aspects of the environment, appraise what they see in terms of their own experience, evaluate what they experience in terms of their needs and values, act based on their perception of the situation that confronts him or her, an individual. Thank you for being there.